So this vlog officially starts, this BattleTech vlog officially starts our 3028 technical manual review. We're going to be going A to Z, light to assault, looking at the mechs historically in this time period, building that Tactica checklist, putting out some ideas to answer the eternal question, right? Would these mechs have a place in your list? Would these mechs have a place in your playstyle? But also being aware of some of the different configurations and mechs that your opponent might throw at you. So we're going to jump in with the lightest mech. I think of it as a tank with legs, exploring the flea. So in the narrative, this mech is a light, cheap scout type mech. And of course, the first question is, in BattleTech, tonnage is the formula where things kind of get a little bit nebulous in between, right? There's that middle zone of a high-end heavy light mech and a low-end light medium mech. It's in the game, things flip immediately, but in some of these configurations, as you make the jump, it's hard to see the difference. And we see this with light mechs and almost proto mechs or some of the similar weight class vehicles, that line blurs a little bit. So that's the first thing I look with the flea. What does it really bring to the table in that weight class being so light compared to a tank? Now, in the narrative, a mech is a mech. I don't want to be in the ranks of the dispossessed, and even the lightest mech has value in terms of an RPG or social status. How does that translate over to the table? Well, mechs traditionally over vehicles can navigate terrain better. They have the ability to generally move faster and be more consistent because they don't suffer motive hits. You could go to internal damage. You could get a leg blown off. You could take damage and your mech moves slower. But what we see with vehicles over time, and facing helps, the facing of the vehicle being straight on, nose down versus getting hit on the side, your vehicle can take a lot of damage, but it starts taking these motive hits. It gets slower and slower and slower. So a mech is pretty consistent. And for that reason alone, mechs have a tremendous advantage over vehicles. That's not the only reason, but it's a primary reason. But again, you're paying in tonnage, C-bills, battle value. So we're jumping in with the flea. First thing you do is you look at the weapon list on this mech. And right away, you're like, Fritz Leike, I like this. We've got two medium lasers. This alone on a light mech, a light mech, is awesome. Most have one as a primary weapon, and then as a secondary weapon, maybe some machine guns or a very light SRM 2-pack or a flamer. The fact that it has two, that has redundancy. Those are two shots that it's going to be able to push out, and with the minimal heat sinks, you're going to raise heat a little bit, but you can move and shoot those two medium lasers pretty consistently. Medium laser, for the battle value, for the range, for the damage output, for the heat, is one of the best weapons in the game. So I'm getting a buy-in with two medium lasers on a light mech, low battle value, low C-bill. Interesting. Then we've got two machine guns, flamer, and two small lasers. These are a lot of weapons on a light mech. I mean, this is, it's a little bit more dynamic than this, but essentially we're just looking at a box on legs, kind of a war walker with a lot of different weapon systems. Now, this is where the flea breaks down a little bit, because if you saw this configuration on a medium mech, and there are some medium mechs that have this configuration, right away you'd say, well, this has got some bite, and it's got the armor to back it up. You look at the flea's armor in the technical manual and you're like, is there a mistake? Is there a mistake here? You get hit by anything other than a medium laser or a weapon that has five damage output. You go right to internals or you potentially get blown off. And even taking a 5-point damage hit or less is going to strip the armor or possibly breach the armor. There is, I'm not saying go with all zeros. And if you regularly play light mechs, you know they don't have a lot of armor. It's the speed. It's the speed that keeps them up. The flea's got, paper thin doesn't even describe it. Okay, well, Fritz, it's a light mech, right? We're going to keep moving. But the speed really isn't that great. In my opinion, I mean, there's some very, very slow light mechs like the Urban Mech. There's some faster light mechs like the Hussar. But I would expect the Flea to at least be pretty fast if you're not going to have that type of armor, at least substantial, for a light mech. You're looking at 6'9 movement, 6 walk, 9 run, no jump. Well, if I don't have jump, then I want to see Locust type speed on there. What also hurts us is the configuration of the weapons. So in order to bring, I have all these weapons, I want to use them, even if I'm going to push the heat, maybe I'll do a light mech alpha strike, I want to push that, I've got to get point blank. I've got to get super, super close with the Flea. I've got to get one hex away, and I don't want to be in the front of any mech because they're just going to punch and kick me. I want to get that rear armor, you know, the usual, but that means I have to get extremely close. I can't even say in a Locust configuration, keep at a distance, medium, maybe long range with the medium laser, fire off the one shot. Maybe if I've got a configuration with the LRM, fire those off, but I'm moving. I'm staying out of the way. The fact with the Flea and how that operates, it puts it in a very, very interesting spot. Okay, the Tactica checklist, and then we're going to turn it over to you guys. This is a fun machine. It is. You've got a lot of close-in weapons. If you can eliminate and isolate a single target, if there was an infantry stand or two, I would probably try to take that on. And that's worth the battle value because I don't have to pull off my T-Bolt or Battlemaster, which I should never be doing, to take out infantry. But the Flea will kind of work it, and that's in its trooper configuration, that was kind of the idea behind it. Moving from that perspective, I can eliminate one infantry stand, take a little bit of damage from the second, and then eliminate the second with the machine guns and the flamers, medium, small lasers. I can engage from a distance, maybe try to run, maybe try to scoot and shoot, but you have to be absolutely on top of your game. No room for error. I mean, there's no room for error as a light mech pilot anyway, but absolutely no room with the Flea. You get hit by anything. You take an AC-10. You take a 20-pack hit, you know, on average, that spread with an LRM, 15-pack, you're going to be leaving pieces behind you and be in a lot of trouble. So the question I leave to you guys with this mech, and again, we're just looking at 3028, page one, jumping in with the first mech, keeping that perspective in mind, are you better off taking a Scorpion light tank? Are you better off taking some light vehicles for the battle value? Or is there a specific reason to take the Flea other than playing for the lulls?